Hey, Al, it's Brian Lund. Welcome back to Rome to the Wars, the Greek City-States. Kind of last time we took out Neapolis and Grand Conquest. And we're working on Messana here, the last Scipiae settlement. So join us today as we try to take out the last Scipiae holdings, the 10,000 Scipians, loyal Scipians that are still alive. Their whole families here. Their best generals in an army that is very small. These are the truths of the battle. But, yeah. Let us see if we can... If I can talk, that would be another one. If we can indeed defeat the Scipiae. Also, the Brutii here. Who shall die this day? Yes. I know you're right there. You're right there. He could come down. No, he won't be able to reach, but, He'll probably try to come down. But I have a 21% chance to kill him outright. Which would be nice. And, of course, when Doros comes back up, I think we're just going to go sneak the other Brutii settlements. Because that would be smarter. Cut off their finances and then take them out. So, alright. Whew! You ready for us? I'm getting excited. We have a chance to kill the Scipiae here. Save the turn. And, of course, they're going to attack. They're not going to attack with everything. That's smart. That Scipiae intelligence. Aulus Scipio here is not a good commander. He's in charge of... Oh my... What are they doing? This army's horrible. I kind of feel bad for them. They're just going to get their faces wrecked a little bit. Oh man. Well. I won't stop them. So let's go. If they want to die, they will die. I'm not sure why they didn't use their faction leader in this battle. That would be very beneficial, as he's a good commander, and he's got some good troops under him, and he's a faction leader, so he's got a big garrison. He's got a big army of, or he's got a big unit of good cavalry. But, again, not going to argue with him. Suicide if there is their only option.
You smell something ripe. That's your enemy. That's what fear does to weaklings when they face the proud sons of Hercules. That's what you've done to them already.
Yeah. Darn straight.
Tomorrow we will smile and remember our deeds today. We will drink to the glory of the gods.
Indeed. Short and to the point, Doros. Thank you. Where is their city? Up there. That's actually good, because they'll come in around the same spot, and we won't have to, like, adjust our armies at all. It's actually pretty perfect. Spread out the hoplites, spread out the love. Spread out the hoplites, make sure you know they're there. The song kind of fell apart, I'm sorry. Get all my guitar units. Where's our... Okay, good. Our heavy pelts are on the extremes. Keep these guys over here. And I think we'll have this unit over here. And this unit right here. And that's looking pretty darn good, if you ask me. So let's engage. And I was kind of hoping to go take down these ballistas, but they have cavalry superiority, so that's not going to happen. Let's be honest. Their cavalry superiority is actually going to be pretty hard to counter. But we do have superior upgrades, and they're coming in right there. Kind of annoying. The idea here is hopefully our archers can wear them down to the point where, you know, it's a fair fight. They got cavalry auxilia as well, which is pretty interesting. That probably means that they have a pretty good cavalry stable, which is really good for us. And, yeah, we should be able to train some Greek Cav, maybe. Although, I don't really like Greek Cav. But we'll see. Maybe I will. Maybe I won't. And nice experience on these Christian archers. And, tearing them up already. They don't have any archers. Whoa, need help. Get them. No, don't rout. Get them. What are you doing? Oh, you're getting shredded. Oh, gosh.
Shredded like a piece of paper!
Alright. I suppose. Alright, so both of them routed, but we were able to kill the unit. And, ugh, that wasn't pretty. Well, that's one unit cavalry that we don't have to worry about, I suppose. These guys over here are going to get free rein on us, I believe, unfortunately. And they're starting to shoot at us with that unit. Yeah. Kind of unfortunate, but what are you going to do? Really, what are you going to do? And there we go. Nice route. So we're routing a couple of their units already. It's not looking too bad. Not looking too bad. And these guys are just standing here. We're peltist fighting with them. And I think we're winning. And their army's really disorganized. And they're starting to rout. Very nice. See, our missile attack is way too powerful for them, I believe. What are you getting shot by? Do they have archers? They don't have archers, do they? Oh, ballista. Yeah. I gotcha. That is right, they do have cavalry. Cavalry, what are you doing? Oh, Roman general. Keep this guy defended. I'd like to not lose any of our men if we can. Because that would mean, bad things. And still firing at these guys over here. Doing okay. It's a pretty stalemate-y right now. But as soon as the battle starts going, then we shall see. We shall see indeed. And not sure what these guys are up to. They're about to get shredded by our archers, though. Very nice. I'm game for that. And here's one of their generals, and their other generals, two generals over here. Those three units we've got to watch out for. Very heavy cavalry. And like I said, they do have cavalry superiority. And they have number of general superiority. They have a lot of superiority, which is unfortunate. But I think we definitely have the infantry superiority and the range superiority. And right now we have the number superiority because they've lost about 40% of their men already. Just to archer pressure alone, which is pretty amazing. And these guys are silver. Very cool. And I'm just kind of waiting to see what they're up to, because they're not really telling any information about what they're about to do, which is annoying. But it doesn't mean that we have more time to shred them with our archers. That is the bonus. And Stadi moving up, they're gonna Pila. Can't really do anything about that, like I said before. There's nothing we can do about that. Doros, you need to get over here, because they're threatening with their cavalry on this side. And they're charging in. They're charging in. Over here as well. And their general is going buck nuts. And he is losing. Kill him. Kill him. Kill him. Yes. Make him retreat. He didn't rout. But he made him retreat, which is good enough. In my books, that's a victory. So we're going to charge in here with our generals and try to take out this general here. I think we can do it. Right in the back. Boom. There we go. Nice! We got him. Get him. Kill him. Doesn't really matter, but... Nice, we got him. Perfect. There we go. Alright, so they are fleeing. And it is looking pretty good right now. As we didn't really lose that many hoplites at all. And they've lost a lot of units. But, this guy we didn't kill, unfortunately. He's gonna stay unkilled. And we still can't go out here. They still have quite a bit of cavalry. So they're gonna keep firing their ballistas at our men. Fortunately, the ballistas aren't doing too much. As ballistas seem to not do often. And there's so many juicy Scipiae that we could be running down. But again, the cavalry is what I'm worried about. Actually, I have a plan. May be able to break them. Although they look to be pretty happy, which is unfortunate. But if we get him right here, that'll be one unit down. There, yes! Very nice. Very good. But their general's coming over. Actually, we can kill him. We can get him. And we will. We will get him. Get right in there. Get him. Get him. Kill him good. This is a risk, but it's a risk I'm willing to take. Very nice. And we lost experience on our main general, actually, which is kind of funny. And now we can just rout them. We can just harry them. Because this cavalry is not going to do anything there. It's literally not going to do anything. And continue the battle. Hunt down as much as we can. Oh, these Ecrites are slow. That's very nice. And we're able to hunt them down a little bit. There we go. Look at that. Free cavalry kills, baby. Yeah! So, yeah, it looks like the Scipii are pretty much done for. They're going to just survive for a few more turns, but, in terms of relative success, it's pretty low. Just hunt down as many as we can so that the Juliana Scipio doesn't really have much to cobble up. And they're not able to train any units. They are able to... No, we bought the only mercenaries that were available. So, I mean, we pretty much have every advantage on them currently. And, man, these guys are... Either these Ecrites are slow or our cavalry is pretty darn fast. Because, generally speaking, you're not able to catch them like that. Just run down this column of men here. And some more Hastati, Ballistas, Town Watch to run down. Run them all down. The Romans deserve nothing more than death. I mean, though, in this timeline, the Romans haven't really done anything atrocious. But, it's bad enough. Anything is bad enough. Just knowing them from a different timeline is enough to warrant their death. And these guys are going down. And the final unit of Scipii on the battlefield is these Hastati. And let's watch them die in glorious normal speed. The rundown of the dogs. Run down those dogs. Very nice. Very good indeed. Let's look at the statistics here. Clear victory. Oh man, we barely lost over 100 total. I mean, after we retrained casualties, we actually lost about 200, but the Chirurgeon is pretty nice. And look at these archers. Look at that. 400. 400 with the archers. 400. 200 with the archers. That's a half unit of archers, too. I mean, gosh. Another 200 down there. That's amazing. Heavy peltasts didn't really do too much. But that's okay. Mercenary hoplites did good. Everybody did good. Who's the best hoplite unit? These two are pretty good. A couple of them didn't do anything, which is fine. So, very nice. Divide and conquer. It works sometimes. Sometimes it doesn't work. And generally speaking, I like to stick... I just like to have one army that just deaths everything. And, yeah, so the Scipii have been defeated there. See if they can cobble anything else up. And, of course, their ships are under attack. Why wouldn't they be? And the Bruti have sieged, as I predicted they may. Neapolis could fall. That would be kind of unfortunate. That'd be definitely a big setback, but I think we can hold that army at least. But if this army comes down, no. We're not going to be able to hold that. But we did get new unit armor hoplites there, and no upgrades for Mr. Awesome Sauce here. Doros the Brave! Very cool. Sanguary. Oh. Well. Utterly fearless. Plus 4 morale. Nice. This guy's a great commander. I love it. I guess we can chill here. I mean, there's nothing else for us to do, really. With that ship. Yeah. But they cut off a lot of our trade here, which is unfortunate. And we kill that captain. We missed! Come on! Whatever. Just making sure we're building stuff everywhere. I think we are. Which is very good. And they're moving out some men. That's fine. Looking good here. I'm just glad they didn't attack Croton or Regium first. Honestly. That would be kind of annoying. But, yeah. Anyway, 5 turns until the Scipiae are dead. And we'll see if they try to break the siege next turn as well. Elus survived? He survived. Interesting. And so did Flavius. We only killed one of their generals. Take it or leave it. But let's save the game and end the turn. Zoom in. Don't forget that. And there we go. He's going to try again. And let me guess. Yeah, they merged. Oh my gosh. These guys just want to die. They just want to die. All right. Look at this guy is pretty darn good. He used to be the leader of the Senate. That is interesting. Drillmaster. His men aren't that good though, which is nice. Like generally, if you have a really good guy like this, you're gonna have like good experience. Like Doros here is gonna have, he has 4 experience, so he's pretty good. Doros the Brave versus Julianus the Cunning. That is pretty cool. So, without further ado, perhaps the last Scipiae battle ever. So, I'll congratulate them for a good try on the campaign, but ultimately futile. Let's engage! The strong did what they could, and the weak suffered what they must. Yes, indeed, that's what is going to happen to the Scipiae. They're going to suffer what they must. Yes. Indubitably. And, we just heard a speech on the last one. We don't need to hear another one. Same exact map, of course, because we're in the same position. Why would it be different? Same setup as last time, although we don't need it quite as thin, I don't think. I would imagine. I'm not 100% on that, though. And they did shoot a bunch of our archers up with their ballista, which was kind of annoying. I mean, honestly, you're just going to shoot up our archers with your ballista? Like, why are you hating? But fortunately, their army consists of a lot of Town Watch, which means, fellow viewers, we got this whole unit back? We got this whole unit back. That's pretty sweet. But anyway, as I was saying, what that means, friends and viewers, is that we have range superiority. Pretty much, Veltes, I mean, and Pila. We're going to take shots from those, I'm sure. But, and we nearly have cavalry superiority. There's no need to send out my cavalry to go die. We could probably pick up this general, honestly, with our two units. But, again, there's no need to risk that kind of thing. And since we're so close to victory, we don't need to risk it. I mean, at the beginning of the game, there was a time when risking that kind of thing is useful. But now that we have a commanding lead against the Scipiae, there's no need to risk our commanders. Or the success of our army on, just trying to kill them a little faster. Okay, maybe I should have kept it a little wider. But Town Watch, again, is, even if they're flanking, Armored Hoplites aren't going to do anything. So I'm not too worried. Although they will have cavalry here that's going to outflank us. We do have the mercenary hops and the armor, or the peltas here, so that should defend against the cavalry pretty nicely. Just watching them advance. And let's see, they've already lost 10% to our archers. Which is better than the other army, I guess, statistically speaking. And they're going to charge in. Perhaps. I guess our line of hoplites. What can they do? No, really, what are you planning on? Oh, that is wise. This is a winning strategy. This is a winner strategy. And I don't like that. Get out, get Nicanor. Oh, did I forget to? Yes, I did. Really? No, we don't need to risk him. We don't need to risk. There's no need to risk. But we do need to do something over here. Because there's a lot of bloodshed. And, what are you doing? Why are you so... that's not good. Kill these Town Watch. There we go. All right. Now we have a good shot at killing this little detachment over here. I was going to charge right into that general and try to kill him. Oh, for killing him, that's the wrong side. And oh. Oh, shoot, we didn't have the things down! You can't kill us. There we go. Get him. Get him. Not get because there's not Yo, get back. Get back. Come on. Don't die on me, dude. I want you to get back. Come on. Get out of there. This is not the time to fight. This is time to flight. Fight or flight, you know? I have no idea what these guys are doing. It's not working for them, I don't think. Alright, I guess they're just going to send in their general to go die. Okay with that. Big cavalry fight over here. We should be able to contain him as long as he stays on. There we go. There we go. Continue to battle. And run them down. If we don't kill their general, it doesn't really matter, I suppose. Yeah, I don't think it doesn't really matter. So, end the battle. Go all first there, sir. He just wouldn't move. And I don't want to lose a guy at this point. So, clear victory. Skippy and I are done. Skippy, I have been defeated. Pardon one offense and encourage the commission of many. Yes, that's my tactic against the Romans. Do not allow them to do anything, or they'll make you pay for it. Victory! And, what else can they do? They're just going to survive for 4 turns and, succumb to our superior might, basically. Actually, I'm going to see if I can just occupy Masana and then just upgrade it to a city or a large city. That would be kind of cool. And we got a bunch of money. Sparta. Academy would not be bad for you. Rhodes. Might as well get that. Syracuse can go ahead and get another good thing going. I can't talk. Blacksmith of the Rune Caledonia would be helpful. Ellis can get a practice range as well. And Corinth can go get a... They're actually growing pretty good now. Pretty good clip. Okay, Gore doesn't give you. It's the large city one. Okay. We'll just get another farm upgrade. Why not? More money. And, looks like they're going to siege here. Gonna be a little tough, but I think we'll be okay, guys. I just don't see them doing anything that painful. And this army disappeared. That's either really good or really bad. No, he's right there. Never mind. I shall speak with them at once. Do you guys want a ceasefire? Oh my word, will you just stop? There's no need. Who shall die this day? He won't hit a thing. Wait, did you lose subterfuge? No. He's a dead man. There we go. And Dionysus the killer. Oh, Dionysus of... Wait, who got that? I have no idea. Our faction leader, maybe? Where is our faction leader? Dionysus. Oh, he's right here. Dionysus the killer. Yeah, okay. Fair enough. We need some more proper sons of Sparta. Let's look at our family tree. We are getting old fast. Oh, these guys are just not getting prego. Come on. Get some children going. You, I like you. We got some children, but really, honestly, we need more children. This isn't good. We need children, guys. Guys have... Derprana. Yeah, he died. I wish he didn't die. He was nice. What are you gonna do, though? But, yeah, let's save it. And, probably just gonna go until, you know, Masana falls. And, we'll probably have to fight Captain Opius here. Right now, in fact. So, Captain Opius is going to attack. They have gladiators. Which, against normal infantry are pretty hard to defeat. But, against... You know, hoplites, which they can't even push in on. They got nothing, so. Pretty standard fare here. So, let's go. About 1,000 Greek soldiers versus 1,500, you know, poor Roman soldiers. We got a pretty nice army, well upgraded. They don't really have any upgrades, and their armor's not too nice. But, we'll defend. And we shall win, hopefully. Nothing is inconsistent, which is expedient. I don't really know what that means at all. I could not tell you what that is saying. I have no idea what that means. To me, that's saying absolutely nothing. So let's start deployment. They have a spy in our city. If I would have known that, I would have used my assassin to kill him. Alright. What are we building? Academy? Right there? Okay. So, we're going to have to defend the town center, because we literally cannot defend the walls. That would just be the worst idea. This isn't a really good defensive spot. We're pretty much what we're going to do here is we're just going to kind of line up. I'm just going to kind of spread out like that. And we'll deal with them as they come up. Should be interesting. They definitely look really cool when it's kind of like twilight out. Twilight Awa. Very sexy bronze shielding on these hoplites. The flag bearers have cool crests on their helmets. And yeah, they're just going to run in. Buck nuts. Oh, their captain... Really, your captain is in a town watch unit. How desperate. And they are getting shot. Maybe some oil will come down? Maybe? No, I don't think so. That'd be nice, though. It's great to get some boiling oil coming down. Just... Do some damage. It's really hard to get boiling oil to activate in this game. Because generally speaking, on bigger cities where you have that, it's a lot easier to take ladders or something and take the walls that way. And you're not going to experience boiling oil much in this game, unfortunately, like I said. But their Velite gladiators are coming in first. Good. Their most powerful unit. First. Always nice. Should be able to hunt them down. And they're coming over here. What are they... They're going to take a really long path through a lot of towers to get all the way over here just so that you can end up in pretty much the same spot. Unless they're going all the way around over here. In that case, that's going to take him forever. And I'll be able, definitely be able to react to that. So goodbye to the... Oh, Principes. Nice. Beautiful. Wasting Principes and Velites. Because we don't really have much range power. We have one unit of archers. With some upgrades, so... Not bad, but... Why are they? Why don't they just come down the center here? That'd be a lot easier, and it would end up in a lot less death, as well. I mean, come on, guys, use your naggins. I guess they don't want to. Armored hoplites here, going good. Triumphal column, I like that name. Triumphal column. So the first part of this, game is going to be killing the Romans. I'll say probably until maybe part 15-20, we'll be killing Romans. And then I'll transition into a probably anti-Macedonian campaign, and that'll be interesting as well. We'll see, though. See how it pans out. And the first men of the Stati unit here are going to... They're already tired. Come on, what are you doing? You're not going to do anything to us. Come on. I haven't fought the Bruii in a long time, though. This is about time, huh? Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Are you going to clip these guys? Yes, you are. Nice. It just mowed them down. If you let him kill you, I swear... That's a totally different unit. So let's watch the Histati try to get in here and do damage. And a friendly fire. But a thin formation like this is not good against hoplites. You're never going to get any kind of push because, I mean, you might get a guy in here like this. Okay, I'll give you that. But, they're just going to rout. But I was going to say, you're not going to be able to get around the flanks of the unit and hurt them, which is what you need to do against hoplites. You need to outflank them. Without outflanking them, you cannot defeat hoplites or phalanx troops, any kind of, hoplite based. Honestly, armored hoplites is my favorite. That's good English. Armored hoplites are my favorite hoplite unit. Just because, they're very balanced. They're one turn to train. They got very good defensive stats. Take lots of missile abuse and stuff. But, yeah, they're very balanced. But I do like Sacred Band from Carthage and Spartan Hoplites, of course. Those are very good. We may have to deal with Sacred Band from Carthage at some point. Let's hope we don't soon. Hopefully we'll have good upgrades by then and we'll be able to handle them, but Sacred Band are definitely very powerful. And Town Watch here. You just can't. It just doesn't work. You can't do what they're doing. This is an example of how not to fight a phalanx force. Is be disorganized. Run in a column so you can get scooped up really easily. And don't flank them at all. That's how you lose. If your goal is to lose against hoplites, it's pretty easy. It's not hard. But, they did get a little bit in here, but then they retreated. They could push this advantage. Although, honestly, these guys are still going to lose in melee combat against our armored hoplites. Like, with the swords out, even with the, combat penalty. They're still going to lose. And now, that wasn't a horrible push. See, they're getting some kind of pressure here. But, since they're inferior units, they're not going to be able to do much of anything. And more Principes coming up. Trying to fight. See, because if you get a guy in here like this, it's taking these guys off from, putting the spear out. And it's, it takes them a while to kill the guy in melee range like that. So there's so many benefits to being able to push in. But it's just so hard if you're doing it like this. Especially because, when they get in melee mode, they'll just creep up like this. And they're not going to get inside at all. If they're creeping up like that. And the Pila is doing good. Don't get me wrong. Pila is doing some good damage. But you need more than just Pila Pila is good. Definitely. Like I said. I just said that, literally. And, oh. That's unfortunate. They're just going to route right into us a little bit. That's not helpful. He just clubbed him with his sword. These Principes, a nice charge, but again, you're not breaking through with the Phalanx line. And again, your death is certain. If not completely. So we'll have our general run them down a little bit. I believe that's in order. And maybe. If we can just route him right there, that would be pretty cool. Yep, there we go. So we'll hunt down all these Principes here. All these really great Roman units that they're just wasting. It's very depressing. And these just started going down. But honestly, you know, Principes and Inside really aren't that good against armored hoplites. You just need a lot of, you know, skill and luck involved with killing armored hoplites. Where I don't even know where the Velite Gladiators went. Like, I haven't even seen them at all. But yeah, you got to be a little determined if you want to kill armored hoplites with Primaran units. It's pretty easy with like legionary cohorts and stuff because the Pila is so devastating that just tears them up. And then in melee, they can actually stand against the spear points pretty nicely. But as far as Primaran, they just don't have the stats. And I think that is their last unit. Now they have a unit over here. These are the Velite Gladiators. Getting cut down by the towers. Coming in through the back. A little late. I don't... Who is ordering this? I'm just mad at this army for... I don't know. Just trying to give you guys hints on what not to do. Definitely don't split up your army if you don't control the walls. Because it gives the walls, you know, each... Like, you get more fire from the walls. And they can just kill stuff. Like, you know, these guys are pretty good, but they're half depleted, and they're probably missing... Because they have 2 HP, so they're probably... Most of them are missing a good chunk of that HP. Like, I'd say at least, you know, probably 3/4 of the guys surviving have at least one HP missing. Which makes them extremely easy. Yeah, and they're just getting shredded from the back now. Losing HP and losing men. So we'll get a guy over here to deal with those when they come. And another thing, if you're fighting a Greek city, a Greek nation, and you know you're going to fight a Greek nation, getting a lot of infantry is very important. Because if you're outnumbered by the phalanx units, it's incredibly difficult to surround them. Incredibly. Because if they have more phalanxes than you have infantry, if you surround them, you know, they'll get an advantage in the middle. They'll get an advantage somewhere. And part of your armor is going to start breaking. And you might... The point is... it's very hard if you don't have enough infantry to fight them. So, building a lot of infantry and some cavalry is probably the best way to fight the Greek states. Because if you can, you know, pin them with your infantry and do okay, do good damage with the Pila, pin them with your infantry, and then wheel around with the cavalry and hit them in the back, you have a good shot at defeating them. And that is probably the best way to kill hoplites, honestly. Pin them and wheel charge. Wheel around and charge. Pivot charge, you know. Because generally, you know, the Greek cities, the computer as the Greek cities doesn't really train much cavalry. And, yeah. Even me, who loves cavalry, isn't training much cavalry because I can't really afford to, you know, go get the buildings for it. And stuff like that. But eventually, yes, eventually I'll have great strides in cavalry technology. Especially in, like, Syracuse. We'll get some Macedonian cavalry pretty soon, I think. Do some good work, and I'm just kind of waiting for them to come die. I should speed it up. That'd probably be better. A2% killed. The general is very late to the party. And you generally want to have your general. You generally want to have your general, you know, pretty close to the action at all times. but not in the action, because if your general rallies, you're pretty much done in a city attack. But if your general's there providing support, your other men are less likely to rout. And see, these guys just can't push. They can't push a hoplite unit. They're useless against hoplites, but it'll take them a while to die. Sure. I'll give them that. And maybe the Zestati will come around and flank them. But I got four other units in case this fails. And I got cavalry support as well, if need be. And, you know, they are dying. And their general just routed. There you go. See, Pila right there. And this is a good example. This is a good unit to pin with. You know, you're not able to push into the unit and kill them and all, but it's a good pin, because these guys have to, if they turn around, they're going to get killed. Because these guys are definitely going to beat them in melee combat. That guy didn't, but generally speaking, like, this guy's going to go die. I'm sure of it. These two guys are dead. Unless they're just really bad, I don't know. Yeah, see, he got stabbed in the back. I'm going to lose our flag bearer in the unit, but, yeah, see, they can push, and, ooh, that's not good. Yeah, hate to see that kind of thing happen, especially routing right into our men, and, Stadi also routing, ooh, right into our men. I think they want to go this way, but, towards their general, but, it's not always the smartest idea. Hoplites wheeling around trying to kill them all. Kind of fun. Yeah, and definitely you don't want to run your units into a hoplite unit. Like, not... What I mean by that is, like, order them to, like, run into the unit trying to get past their spears, because they'll get torn up. Because if they're running like that, they don't have the defense skill active, and you need that. But, yeah, just some tips for Phalanx armies. Just saying. Anyway, end the battle and clear victory against the Romans. Didn't really lose much at all. Eh! It ended with eh. Eh.
So, let us see what happens if anything else happens this turn.
I don't know. Let's see if they siege again. Please don't. Please don't come down with a big army. That would just be annoying. Okay, good. Ooh. Carthage is posturing. Carthage, what are you up to? I don't like it when you do that. And end of turn report, losing some money, that's fine. And Eumenes is, oh, he's dead too. Gosh dang, see, we need children. Come on, guys, get bang up your wives. I know that sounds horrible. We need some people. These old people are dying. I didn't think that would be the problem that we'd be having. Oh, Gaul has gone to war with Carthage. That's something. And mark it over in here, Dionysus. And I guess crop rotation. If we can get this to a large city, that would be pretty cool. Athena. Sparta is growing pretty nicely. Any army routes? Of course it does. And recruit another one and retrain what we've lost. It's looking pretty good. I want to try, but I think we need some more skill first. There we go. Expert assassin. So he's got 7 subterfuge. So he's got 24% is just not good. Just not good. He must have some kind of spy defense trait, I would imagine. But, like I said, I'm going to keep going until we kill the Scipii here. In fact, we'll build some siege equipment, because this is going to take a while, isn't it? If I don't. And we'll save it. And end the turn. See what these guys are up to. This old guy here, in particular. And end the turn. Brutii. Doing nothing. I like it. And I don't know what Carthage is going to do. And that's what bothers me. Is that I can't just leave Massana undefended. is the problem. It's bothering me. And agent found. Yada, yada, yada. No buildings constructed that turn. Interesting.
Who shall die this day? Death approaches. Moving to position. He won't hit a thing.
Okay, I kind of want to take a shot at him. Why do I even? Say goodbye to the CPI, guys. I'm defeated. Oh, why did you? I wouldn't lose art. What the heck? Come on, I wouldn't lose that many. Whatever. Anyway. I almost want to. Could we do it? Oh. That is a question. Could we do it? Could we? See, now I like it, because these navies are going to be the enemy of everybody. That's kind of the good part about it. Should we? You know what? No risk, no reward. Let's do it. Yeah, see, we're fine. Temple of the Hermes here. This will be a Greek town, so I'm not too worried about that. And we'll repair those. And we should, in theory. Oh, we really can't train armored hops here. That's annoying. But faction destroyed. How's the CPI? Very nice. Very nice indeed. So that's one Roman family gone. And I didn't want to zoom over there. And taking a good swath of territory. Chicken over here. Everything's looking pretty good. I think I'm going to save it and do one more turn. And we'll call it good for this session here on this Saturday morning. So, it's end of the turn. Moving down an assassin. Oh, okay, good. He's going to attack Syracuse. All right. That works. That works actually pretty swimmingly, if we're going to be honest. Because I should be able to handle him. I hope. We'll see. No, we got plenty of men. We got extra armored hoplites. Yeah, they are pony infantry, but they should get turred up by the walls. Turred up by the walls. And, lots of stuff to build. Okay, I like. What do we got? Yeah, I think it's time to start building some military here. So we're going to go for Temple of Nike first, I guess. +2 experience. And then we're going to go for the armor combo. And then this is done. So we can put that down to low tax rate, get some growth. Syracuse. Armor barracks is useless. I would like a Temple of Nike. Definitely. In Caedonia, you can go ahead and get stables. Ellis, you are done as well, so you can stop and grow. Neapolis. I guess you can grow as well. See no point in not. And Masana can get the... Oh, Masana's grown. Perfect. Perfecto. And yeah, we can train Greek cavalry here, but... I don't know. Wait, why can't we... Oh, we are retraining already. I'm like, why can't we retrain him? But, train another unit of cavalry. And things are looking pretty good. So I'll turn this into a nice Greek city. And then I think we'll move out with our dude. We'll plop over here. And then after that, we'll build 1, 2, 3 ships. And try to pump up our navy. And that's looking pretty good. And Silas Malaga is sieging Syracuse. But I think that's all we're going to do today for this episode of Rome to the War. It's the Brutia, yeah. As the Greek cities, yes, that's what it is. Good work. And we did some good work here. We killed the Scipiae. So next turn, hopefully Doros will go up and start conquering the Brutii. Oh, this is a large city now. Interesting. And is this a large city as well? No. I guess I just paid for this one instead. That's fine. I'll take out this large city, move up here, take out this city up here, or town, or whatever it is. Because I know there's one up here. And they'll come down and hit up Capua. And that'll be another family gone. So, that'll be pretty nice. But join us next time when hopefully we can, do some work against the Brutii. So, thanks for watching. Brandon Lawrence signing out. Have a great day.